First and foremost, the setup that you can use regarding the to-do list and task management is ToDoIst. So ToDoIst is a nice and easy task management and to-do list app that is awesome because it also syncs with Google Calendar. So the nice thing about ToDoIst is that you can pretty much capture everything. And what I recommend in this system is to essentially utilize what you have here. And I've already done all these. So essentially here, what you can do is add any sort of task that you want. So today, record this video, schedule it for today, edit this video, schedule for tomorrow, and upload this video, schedule for Thursday. So essentially this setup is going to hopefully utilize GTD. I recommend you using GTD or some sort of priority system so that you can figure out what you need to do and organize your life in a way that makes this simple. So if you guys want to check out GTD, I have a video on that I will put in the description as well as link it in the cards. But essentially it's a system that has a nice weekly review where you can figure out what exactly your things that you need to get done are, and you can organize in this system, and you take a task management system like ToDoIst and incorporate that principle with it, and you will find yourself getting a lot of things done. So all these different things would be organized in this system with GTD. You'd have a weekly review template, which is nice in ToDoIst. This makes it very simple and easy for you. I'm trying to make this as simple as possible. And with that, we can roll right into Google Calendar. And essentially, what we have here with Google Calendar and ToDoIst is actually really nice. If we go to settings here, we have a Google Calendar integration. So we can add ToDoIst here. I just pressed on the link and it sent me here. So if we go connect calendar, allow the sharing, agree, sync whatever you want here, connect. You can put the event duration as well. All right, so it should be synced up. So if we go to my Google Calendar, so we go to ToDoIst here, you can see that the task is associated with the day, and you can actually set it up in a format that's nice and easy. So if we go here, today, so we can put today at 4 p.m. That will update into showing actually a specific time for it. So as you can see, after a second here, it updates and shows you exactly the time. So if you want to have that calendar incorporated with your to-do list, you can have this nice integration, and essentially you can either do a block schedule and have these at the top, not integrate it, do what you want. But the whole point is it can sync up with a calendar, which is really nice. And I personally think that that's one of the best integrations you can have with ToDoIst. And then having this Google Calendar functionality is really nice as well, because it connects with the last part of our trifecta that's synced up. So we have a to-do list, we have a calendar, and last but not least, what we can do is we can have notes right on the sidebar here. So as you can see, there is the notes right next to it. So as you can see right here, if you're working throughout the day, you can take notes. So this is an example note I can put in Google Keep. The different types of notes that you can have are awesome, because you can make little checklists, you can make different drawings and stuff like that. So this is a nice place to jot down ideas or notes that occur, or obviously you can quickly capture it in your capture inbox in ToDoIst. But first and foremost, you can do something like this where you have consistent notes for the day. So you can even just do a daily journal on your calendar, right? So it's like 9:28 journal. This happened. I recorded a few videos and it was nice. To be honest, personal finance tracker video was kind of rough. Lol. And that can not be something as dumb as that, but it can be anything you want it to be. So if we go into the full-fledged Google Keep here, you can add labels to different things. You can archive them. You can do, it's like daily journal, right? So you can set it up so that we go here, we can see the daily journals in this label. If we archive something, it'll end up here. This is just a nice little way to have random notes come up. What's nice is if you're on your phone, you can do a drawing, you can add notes with images. Google Keep is very simple. However, I will say it's not bad. Like, it's one of those things where people just want an option to do something. This can be how you get your daily journal. So you have your jotted notes, right, while you're doing the Google Calendar stuff. But what you can do is you can pin this here. So you can type throughout the day. And then afterwards, you can have your daily journal occur. Got it. And then you can go throughout this system and say, for example, you don't want to just do daily journal. You want to have it so that it is set up through like my September journals or my October journals. And then you move forward with that. So we change labels. We add another one, October or September journals. And then you can kind of utilize this as a journal database. We can have video ideas. So for example, we just have an idea for something like it's taking new notes, make a video idea. Let's see, I need a video idea to Google Keep tutorial. How to use Google Keep would be a good video for people who want another note taking option. And then that label would be like video. And that's a way to sync everything together. So as you can see, you can pin what you want here on your Google Calendar. You can have your tasks come into Google Calendar. You can choose whether you want to have a block schedule or just have the tasks come in. And then everything is synced up. It's nice and simple. You have somewhere to have your to-do list. You have somewhere to have your calendar, and you have somewhere to take your notes all in one place. It's great.
So I hope those apps are good enough for you. To me, they're pretty good. I'd use this system if I didn't love Notion so much. But you know, I'm me, and you might be better than me. You probably are. As we wrap this thing up, if you guys could go and check out the rest of my videos on productivity here, I would really appreciate it. And with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.